Today I'm going to show you how to replace the charging port in your iPhone 6S. Before you jump into this semi-difficult repair, make sure that it's not just like a piece of dust or lint blocking your charging port. You can usually reach in there and clean it out with a small brush or a toothpick. I will link all of the tools and parts you need down in the video description of this video. There's two screws down at the bottom of the phone. They're pentalobe screws. Unscrew them, and then you can lift up on the screen with a suction cup and pry between the metal frame of the screen and the metal frame of the phone. You want to make sure not to bend the screen at all as you're prying up, or else you'll break your LCD, and it'll turn into a more costly repair than just your charging port. There is adhesive surrounding the outside of the phone. I separated that with my plastic pry tool, and then the screen was able to just lift up away from the body. Be very careful. Do not bend the screen up past 90 degrees. There are four screws here and a metal plate. I will link a free PDF screw chart organizer in the video description that will help out. There's three ribbon cables down here. You can just unsnap them from the phone like Legos. Then there's a metal plate and two screws here for the charging port. Then there's two screws down here for the vibrator motor. It just pulses back and forth instead of spinning around like a regular vibrator motor. You can see the contact points for the charging port. I'm disconnecting the battery and disconnecting the charging port from the motherboard, pulled away from the loudspeaker. Then there's one wire cable down here on the motherboard as well. Just kind of lift that up. Be very careful with that. It is fragile. There's three screws here for the loudspeaker, three screws here for the headphone jack, and then six screws here right next to the charging port itself. Make sure to place all those on your screw organizer that you printed out from the video description. Then there is one hidden screw underneath this black tape. Scrape away the black tape and find your little hidden guy. Remove it. Pull up the end of this wire cable from the loudspeaker, and the loudspeaker will be able to pull away from the phone body. Here's the loudspeaker. You can see the two gold contacts up at the top. They just rest up against the charging port ribbon cable, and that's how it receives its signal. Then the charging port ribbon cable can lift up away from the phone. Be very gentle, because there are two parts that are still stuck to the phone body. There's a microphone here and then a microphone on the other side as well, held in with this little rubber plastic bit. There's a spot on the screw chart for that as well. Keep it organized, and then you can pull away the other microphone from the phone body. Pull the headphone jack out from its little slot in the phone body as well, and that releases your charging port. You can see the contact points for the vibrator, the loudspeaker, the two microphones, the headphone jack, and the charging port itself. And here's the empty phone body. Take your new charging port. There's probably adhesive on it, so remove all of the safety tabs on top of the adhesive. Set your charging port down into place and put the microphones back in their slot. Make sure the hole lines up with the hole in the frame as well. Otherwise, your microphone won't be able to hear you when you speak. Then you can line up the little rubber piece as well. Get all these screws back into place except for the red one. Leave the red one out for right now. Get the loudspeaker put back into place as well. Once again, all of this stuff will be linked down in the video description. Make sure to get the wire back into place and make sure it's pinched on the top of the loudspeaker. You can see in the top left there. Now you can put in the rest of the screws that hold in the loudspeaker and the charging port, and you can clip the ribbon cable into place. And the wire cable, make sure it's positioned directly on top of its connection before you place it down. Two screws holding the vibrator motor, and then last thing you want to pin down is the cable for the battery. There's the three ribbon cables for the screen. You have your front camera, digitizer, and LCD ribbons. Make sure they're all placed down. And then before I put the metal plate in, I'm just going to turn on the phone to make sure it works. Looks like everything is working fine, but if you have like lines running through your screen, or the screen is white, there's a good chance that your cables aren't plugged in correctly and you're going to want to reseat them and plug them in again. To get the screen pinched down into place, line up the top first, then you can slide your hands down the side and clamp it down into place all the way down. If you have any questions, make sure to leave them in the comments. I do respond fairly regularly. Make sure to put the bottom two screws in the bottom of your phone. Check out a couple of my other repair videos, and don't forget to check out my Instagram. I do more fun things than just taking apart cell phones. Thanks a ton for watching. Hope to see you around.